Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. I am your mentor Manish Mishra and in this session we will discuss 5 more questions from the PIB news. Use this golden period of lockdown for comprehensive study of each and every topic. Alright, so now let's begin with the session. So question number 1 is, the Union Cabinet has recently taken a decision to suspend the MP lads to fight the COVID-19 for how many fiscal years? Guys, MP lads stands for Member of Parliament Local Area Development Scheme, which was launched in 1993. And under this scheme, 5 crore rupees per MP is provided for the development of their respective constituency. Okay, and it enables the Member of Parliament to recommend development work in their constituencies with an emphasis on creating durable community assets based on local needs. And what are these durable community assets? These are like drinking water, okay, drinking water, health facilities, primary education, sanitation, roads, and etc. So these durable community assets are drinking water, health facilities, primary education, sanitation, road, and etc. And initially this scheme was administered by Ministry of Rural Development, but in 1994 this scheme was transferred to Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, headed by Rao Inderjeet Singh, who is Lok Sabha MP from Gurgaon. He is Minister of State Independent Charge for Statistics and Program Implementation. And the recent news is that the Union Cabinet had decided not to operate MP LAD for 2 years, that is from 2021 to 2022. And the funds used to run this scheme will be used to strengthen government's efforts in managing the challenges and adverse impact of COVID-19 in the country. And this fund, which is 7900 crore from the MP LAD scheme, will go to the Consolidated Fund of India. So therefore guys, the correct answer to this question is A, 2 years, that is till 2022. Okay, now next question is, the Ministry of HRD, headed by Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, whose Lok Sabha constituency is Haridwar, launched an online challenge to address COVID-19 in the country with an aim to motivate the students to make new discoveries and perform new experiments and come up with solutions that will help fight COVID-19. What is the name of the challenge? So guys, this challenge is named as Samadhan Challenge. Okay, the name of the challenge is Samadhan Challenge, and let us discuss more about this. This challenge aims to motivate the students to make new discoveries and perform new experiments and come up with solutions that will help fight COVID-19. इसमें क्या है कि ये स्टूडेंट्स को मोटिवेट करेगा ताकि वो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा डिस्कवरीज करें और हमें COVID-19 से लड़ने के लिए मजबूत बनाए. ओके, एंड इसको 5 ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस ने मिलकर लॉन्च किया. एक तो है इनोवेशन सेल ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एचआरडी, एक खुद मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एचआरडी, इसके अलावा ऑल इंडिया काउंसिल फॉर टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड 2 प्राइवेट कंपनीज विच आर फोर्ज एंड इनोवेशियो क्यूरिस. ओके, इन सब ने मिलकर मेगा ऑनलाइन चैलेंज समाधान लॉन्च किया टू टेस्ट द एबिलिटी ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स टू इनोवेट. Okay, and the newly developed measures can be made available to the government agencies, health service, hospitals and other service for the quick solution of such epidemics like COVID-19. And a cash prize of rupees 5 lakh rupees is also will also be provided to the winners. Alright, so guys, the correct answer to the question is D, Samadhan Challenge. Alright, next question is, Ministry of HRD has launched a training module for management of COVID-19 named Integrated Government Online Training Portal to look after the training needs of the frontline workers. Which platform of Ministry of HRD is used to leverage this portal? So let us first discuss about IGOT, which is Integrated Government Online Training Portal. So this portal has been launched on Diksha platform of Ministry of HRD, and it aims at enhancing capacity building of frontline workers to handle the pandemic COVID-19 efficiently. The portal will look after the training needs of the frontline workers, and there are various courses which are launched on this portal for doctors, nurses, paramedics, hygiene workers, government officers, civil defense officers, National Cadet Corps, Nehru Yuva Kendra Sangathan, Indian Red Cross Society, Bharat Scouts and Guides, and other volunteers. and the platform will provide the training module on flexi time and on-site basis so that the COVID response can be delivered at scale for the workforce needed to tackle the pandemic. And the Diksha portal stands for Digital Infrastructure Knowledge Sharing, which was launched in 2017 by Ministry of HRD, and it was launched to provide digital platform for the teachers to learn and train themselves. And also Diksha has already explanation, practice and assessment content linked to NCERT and state curriculum. Alright, so guys, the correct answer to this question is B, Diksha platform. Now next question is, so in the next question, a paragraph is given and after reading the paragraph, you have to give the answer to the questions. Okay, so let us first read the passage. Social trends and growing urbanization are leading to rapid spread of non-communicable diseases such as heart ailment, diabetes and cancer. With the population aging, the elderly will account for nearly 11% of the citizens in 2025. Consequently, there is a demand for greater access to quality care, but expensive treatment costs are making it difficult for uninsured citizens to afford care. The government has launched PM Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana to make available quality generic medicines at affordable prices to all, especially the poor, throughout the country through outlets known as Jan Aushadhi stores. So it is clear that the passage is about PM Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana. So jo hame questions milenge wo bhi isi scheme se related milenge. Alright. So now let us read question number 4. Jan Aushadhi Kendras or stores is considered as the biggest retail pharma chain of the world with around 6200 outlets in 700 districts. Total sale in the financial year 2019-20 has crossed dash and lead to a total savings of approximately 2200 crore for common citizens. Now guys, let us first discuss about the scheme. So this scheme was launched in 2008 by the name Jan Aushadhi scheme. In 2015, another same scheme was launched, Pradhan Mantri Jan Aushadhi Yojana, and in 2016 this scheme was renamed as Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana, in short PMBJP, and it is implemented by Department of Pharma, which comes under the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, headed by DV Sadanand Gowda, whose Lok Sabha constituency is North Bangalore. Now this scheme aims to make available quality generic medicine at affordable prices to all, especially the poor, and it is implemented through the outlets which are known as Jan Aushadhi stores or Kendra. Every year, 7th March is celebrated as Jan Aushadhi Divas, and the prices of Jan Aushadhi centers are 50% to 90% less than the market price, and the scheme is also providing a good source of self-employment with sustainable and regular earnings. Okay, and what about the performance of Jan Aushadhi Kendras? Jan Aushadhi Kendras is considered the biggest retail pharma chain of the world with around 6200 outlets in 700 districts. And the total sales in the financial year 2019-20 up to February 2020 has crossed rupees 390 crores and lead to a total savings of approximately 2200 crore for common citizens, which means this scheme काफी beneficial साबित हो रही है for all the citizens of India. Okay, so now what was the question? The total sales in the financial year 2019-20 has crossed dash and lead to a total savings of approximately 2200 crore for common citizens. So the correct answer to this question is C, rupees 390 crores. Now guys, last question for today is, pharmacists of Pradhan Mantri Jan Aushadhi Kendra are delivering essential services and medicines at doorsteps of patients and elderly during the lockdown period due to outbreak of COVID-19. It is being done under Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana of the Government of India. These pharmacists are properly known with which name? So guys, these pharmacists are properly known with Swasth Ke Sipahi. Okay, Swasth Ke Sipahi, kyunki ye COVID-19 jaisi outbreak ke samay mein bhi ye essential services aur medicines jo hai wo patients ke liye aur jo elderly people hai unke liye doorstep pe deliver kara rahe hain. अंडर प्रधानमंत्री भारतीय जनौषधि परियोजना, सो इनको स्वास्थ्य के सिपाही के नाम से जाना जा रहा है. सो द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज ई, स्वास्थ्य के सिपाही. सो फार्मासिस्ट पॉपुलरली नोन एज स्वास्थ्य के सिपाही ऑफ प्रधानमंत्री जन औषधि केंद्र आर डिलीवरिंग एसेंशियल सर्विसेज एंड मेडिसिन एट डोरस्टेप ऑफ पेशेंट्स एंड एल्डरली एंड इट इज बीइंग डन अंडर प्रधानमंत्री जन औषधि परियोजना. ओके, Okay guys, so that's it for today's session. These were the 5 questions. I hope you like this session. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Milte hain next session mein. Tab tak apna dhyan rakhein aur dekhte rahein PIB 24/7.